Welcome to this video. This is class 5. In this video, we are dealing with resistors in series. We know resistors are used in electrical circuits. A resistor is represented by a simple. This is R. Resistance R. Suppose we have more than one resistance. Here, I am having one more resistance. I can call it as R1 and this one as R2 and third one R3. We can connect these three resistors in a circuit such a way that they are connected one after the other. I will show you the diagram of that, how we connect them in series. This is R1, R2, R3. All these three are connected like this, and that method and the way of connecting one after the other is termed as resistors in series. And we connect this one to a voltage, a battery or cell. So electric current should pass through R1, then R2, R3 and back. So the circuit will give all these three resistors and they are included in the circuit. Now voltage here is given to the circuit and the available voltage is V. I connect one voltmeter here. And let it be V1. This shows the voltage with across R1, and connect another volt here. We can measure a volt here. This is V2, and voltage across the third resistance is V3. If R1, R2, and R3 of different values, these V1, V2, V3 will be different. And as a result, we can have a current in the circuit. As I told, the current flows through R1, R2 and R3 and we get a current I. It can be measured using an ammeter. You can connect ammeter here or there or anywhere. We will get the same current I. Suppose I am having a resistor and connect, instead of this resistance, such a way that the current available or in the circuit is the same I. If this resistance is giving the same current when we connect this R1, R2 and R3, I can replace R1, R2 and R3 by this single resistance, and the resistance, say it is R. This R is termed as effective resistance. In the sense, this is the effect of these three resistances in the circuit. Now you just analyze the circuit. We have one V here and an R here and same I here. We know the relationship. V is equal to IR. R is the effective resistance. Now R1, R2, R3 are there, and if you have that circuit, here the voltage is divided or split into three voltages. Same I, across R1 we are getting a voltage V1, across R2 V2 and across R3 V3. We can write V1 is equal to I R1 because I is common, I is the same, and V2 is equal to IR2 and V3 is equal to IR3. We know available voltage is only V and it is split into these three. So we can write V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Here we have the values of V, V1, V2 and V3. We can substitute V is IR is equal to IR1, that is V1 voltage across R1, plus IR2 voltage across R2 and IR3 voltage across R, resistance 3, R3. I is common here. So we can cancel I and we get an equation. R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. This R is actually the effective resistance of R1, R2 and R3. So this expression gives the value of effective resistance. So once we have three resistors in the circuit and once they are in series, effective resistance is calculated as sum of individual resistances. If the resistors are of the same value, we can have R1 plus R2 plus R3 is three times single resistance. So we can write three times that value. But if it is different, we have to sum up all these three, R1, R2 and R3. And the practical applications of this and the problems, simply we can do without any problem because R1, R2 will be given, effective resistance immediately we can write. And from that we can calculate the voltage across first resistance, second resistance, third resistance, provided we know the values of R1 and R2 and R3. We can do one problem. Here is the problem. Three resistors having resistance 2 ohms, 3 ohms and 5 ohms are connected in series with a 6 volt battery. A. Calculate the effective resistance. B. Find out the current in the circuit. C. Find out the voltages across these resistors. So in the problem we have three resistors, R1 2 ohms, R2 3 ohms and R3 5 ohms, and they are connected in series, so we can have a connection circuit. And it is connected to voltage of 6 volt. Here we can have 2 ohm, 3 and 5 ohm. A. What is the effective resistance? Simply we can find out the effective resistance by that equation we have studied. R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, nothing but 2 plus 3 plus 5, which is equal to 10 ohms. That is effective resistance. First part is over. Now comes, we have to calculate the current through the circuit. So once we get the effective resistance, we know instead of these three, we can consider it as a single resistance of 10 ohm. So what is the current in the circuit? I, we know the equation I is equal to V by R, where V is 6 volt and R is now effective resistance of all the three, 10, that is 0.6 ampere. Second part. Now we have to see the third part, which is the voltage across these resistors, that is voltage across 2 ohm, 3 ohm and 5 ohm. There we were, first we were doing this one in our derivation of this equation. V1 is equal to IR1. So V1 here is equal to I in its resistance to R1. So we can write it is I 0.6 into R1 2. 1.2 volt. Now comes V2, that is across 3 ohm. V2. So V2 is equal to, we can write in the same manner, I the same R2, which is equal to 0.6 into R2 is here 3. 1.8 volt. Next is voltage across 5 ohms, V3. V3 is equal to same equation, IR3, which is equal to 0.6I into third resistance 5, 3 volt. We can just check, we are having 6 volt as voltage of the cell. And it is split into 3 by these 3 resistors, 1.2, 1.8 and 3. On adding these, so we get 6 volt. So we answered all the 3 sections. This is C, V1, V2 and V3, voltages across these resistors. I hope you got clear idea about our series connection of resistors. Now in the coming video, we will be familiarizing with another type of connection of resistors, that is resistors in parallel. Let us see in the next video. Till then, goodbye.